Hi everybody, David Dilling here from Markzware, and today we're going to give you a presentation on how to design in Adobe InDesign for later use in Canva. Really, these tips are quite practical across the line, basically how to design in a desktop app like even Affinity Publisher, Quirk Express, and of course Adobe InDesign. So how to create from the start in those desktop applications for the potential handoff to Canva or other online design ecosystems. This video is more about the font selection, so it can be quite generic in how it's used. However, more and more people are using Canva and InDesign together. We hear about it just about every day, well, just about every week right now. InDesign users are getting asked from their customers, can you host a design for me? Can you set it up in Canva for me? Other people, younger designers a lot, prefer to use Canva, and they have to use InDesign for the day job, but they like to use Canva to help supplement things. And who knows what the future holds, but it's bright for design. Democratizing design is what Canva is all about. Democratizing content is what Markzware is all about. So let's dive into this video. We're going to give a lot of good tips and tricks on fonts to use in InDesign for later converting to Canva. Okay, everybody recording here. Everything's rolling great. Well, welcome to the presentation. Sorry for the long intro. I could have gone on for 5 or 10 more minutes. I just love this topic, the interoperability of designs from desktop to the web environment. The title is, of course, Fonts in Adobe InDesign for Canva, right? Very, very interesting topic. We covered enough of that in the intro. What we have here is how this all started, we started with a list. We started developing a list of fonts that could be used in Adobe InDesign that could also be used in the web environment of Canva. All the quick tips are down below. These are very important to understanding and practice. It's good design practice anyway. But for interoperability, web-safe fonts are very, very important. It's a very good tip because they're available generally on both Adobe set of fonts and Canva, and, you know, like Roboto, Open Sans, Montserrat, etc. Avoid licensing. Or be very careful to understand the licensing. A desktop font might not be, your license for a desktop font might not be the same for on the web or on the internet. So check those out. Stick to simplicity. That'll be a key part of anything in design, but particularly this, or at least most cases, right? And of course, use styles and preview before publish, and we have tools to help do that here at Markzware. But so why Markzware? Well, we have 30 years of experience. And if you combine that all up, it's hundreds of years of experience that is within Markzware that we deal with file conversion and fonts every single day. I mean, every single day, weekends included generally. So we also do have a new DesignMarkz Canva app coming out. If you'd like to beta test that, send me an email. That'll get your InDesign files right up into Canva with a click. And other file types as well, like Microsoft Publisher, even Affinity Publisher. So very interesting way to get your desktop DTP files rather than to Canva. Once again, you might not need the entire document, you know, your entire magazine converted to Canva. Well, you might convert it, but you're only going to use parts of it, right? You're not replacing your desktop tools yet at this point. You're just supplementing them with Canva and the amazing things you can do with Canva with, you know, in animations, video. I'm videoing here now on Canva. Well, I'm looking at my Canon HD recorder, but I'm also recording on Canva natively on their platform. You can read more about IKEA, how they stick to simplicity. I think that's very important. They only use one font family in all their publications and their catalog. What we notice is that you think you have a font that you could easily replace, you know, in Canva or vice versa, Canva to InDesign. This works both ways, by the way. So the fonts change after importing. You know, it seems to lose its entire identity, but in reality, it's all there. We see in our conversion engine and other conversion possibilities with PDFs and what have you. We see what fonts use. It's just the font that is substituted in the app it's being converted to is not being honored. So you need to make sure that you're talking apples to apples. And part of that is designing correctly from the start. Not all fonts. A lot of the fonts in Adobe InDesign will not work in the web environment. That's very important to understand. So with these portals like Canva and even Figma and even Adobe Express, et cetera, becoming more and more popular, you're going to have to start thinking ahead to how is this design going to be potentially used in the future. But there are options that will save you from, expensive substitutions later, and expensive not only from cost of purchasing a font, but just from time and trying to figure out an aggravation. On the technical side, Canva uses the WOFF, the W-O-F-F web type fonts, as do a lot of these web solutions. InDesign uses TrueType font system fonts and OpenType .otf fonts. So TrueType is .ttf and OpenType .otf. And you'll sometimes see these files if you're packaging a file for print on your desktop. You'll see these, extensions, or if you're really a geek and getting into your font database, you'll know what I'm talking about. Okay, just to cut in here real fast, here we are in Flight Check. There's also .ttc TrueType fonts. Actually, what they are is here, .ttc. These are a collection of multiple TrueType fonts in one package. Font packages are actually like mini applications, by the way. You package it with Flight Check, or if you do the similar in InDesign, what you get after you hit package is this, and you see then your fonts in there with all your other elements needed, and you see it's a .ttc. All right, so this is a little mini presentation, part of the bigger presentation. There's also a possibility of converting fonts. Now, we can't recommend this as Markzware, but there's several you can find on the internet using a ChatGPT or Google. You'll find all the different websites for converting these various font formats like WOFF, TTF, and .otf fonts into, interchanging between one and the other. It's not always perfect. It's not even always possible with all fonts. There are licensing issues to consider, but here's just a few of the possibilities that are out there. And you can just see the list below, and the links are in a blog post on our website. I'll put a link to that below as well. Just so you know, there are options for getting your fonts in Canva that will be usable in a design, or that you have it in design that will be usable in Canva. But there are numerous InDesign system fonts which can be the same or very similar to the web fonts that can be used. Let's get a list. This is a list, and I'm just going to go very quickly over this. I'm just going to go slide for slide so you can check them out and understand that these are some great options to use in Adobe InDesign when designing for Canva in this case. And once again, the same could apply for any DTP application, desktop application you're using, and if you want to get it into Canva. We have Lato, a modern classic known for its clean lines and versatility, Roboto, and Open Sans. These are some popular ones right here. And of course, continuing on the popular side of things, these are also fonts that are used by a lot of people, and they can be very effectively used in Adobe InDesign to Canva. So if you use these in your InDesign document, if you end up converting it to Canva, either with our new DesignMarkz or via some other method, you're going to end up with these fonts looking good in Canva compared to not, going all over the place and having to, find another font that's close to it. So these are some great options. Futura, that's a favorite one here at Markzware. Proxima Nova, Century Gothic, Saban, Recoleta, Cooper BT. Continue on the list here. Caslon, I always like Caslon. I like the looks of this one. It's hard for me with dyslexia, but Accidents, Grotesque in Canva. So see, sometimes they have a slightly different name in Canva compared to in InDesign. Also something to be aware of. Then we get to some more funkier ones. This is kind of a cool one. Footager. Rockwell, Gill Sans, Cotford, Canva, not in all regions. Another thing to pay attention to, not all areas will have the same fonts available due to licensing. Now we get into some really neat ones. The Old English. Engravers, Old English.
Transience, that's interesting. Larkin, also kind of cool.
I like this one too, Bank Gothic. The list goes on, and we'll have a list this entire, we'll have this entire presentation down below, so you can get this, and we'll list them in the blog post as well. So, to wrap it up here, it's important to choose cross-platform fonts. I think that's the overall summary from this presentation, is whenever possible, choose cross-platform fonts. Unless you know this is a job that's only for print and only for us internally, and it's only going to be used in InDesign, all right, fine. But no one can foretell the future. And with all these web systems becoming more and more popular, and even other options on the desktop, it's very important to think about cross-platform font issues, not only desktop to web, but also Mac to Win, etc. Stick to simple styles. Don't over, you know, complicate things. That's always very good. And think substitution safe. Like I mentioned, to give you a little more details, we're working on this InDesign to Canva tool. It's very exciting. We're very happy about this at Markzware. It's actually been a 3-year process since we first started with Canva with our other app, ConvertMarkz, which I'll touch on in a second. That was actually our goal from the beginning, is to help InDesign users get content into Canva, because Canva is not going away. We here at Markzware get a lot of PDFs in for file conversion to InDesign and to other ecosystems. And we noticed over the years, more and more Canva PDFs coming in. Producer Canva. And now it's just like daily getting in Canva PDFs that people need to get into. A lot of times in InDesign, basically. But also into Affinity Publisher and other applications. So sign up today to be a beta tester. Here's a link to the webpage. You can check that out by clicking on the links in the presentation below. Like I mentioned, we already have a Canva app in the app store on canva.com, which will allow you to convert your Canva designs right into InDesign. Many testimonials of people that are just so happy and thankful for this. One lady I remember, she had a nonprofit, or she still has a nonprofit. She's a repeat customer. She designs her books in Canva. She just loves it. Canva gave it to her for free. So Canva is very generous with nonprofits and educational and students and all that type of stuff. So this was really, she really ran into a problem, because all of a sudden she needed to print this book. Actually, it was a print-on-demand setup she was going for, so they could print them as they were sold. And they needed it in InDesign. Amazon, some division of Amazon for whatever, you know, print-on-demand system they had, they required it in InDesign for their workflow. She stressed. She found out later with one click. In her case, it was literally one click. Sometimes there's touching up needed, but in her case, it was one click, and it was her book. It was pretty simple, a lot of white space. But also a lot of cool graphics. It was a nice little design. And with a click, she had her book in Canva, now in Adobe InDesign, handed it off to Amazon. And she's, you know, as happy as apple pie, as we say. Really, really interesting. ConvertMarkz, check it out here if you need to go from Canva into InDesign, or Affinity Publisher, or even Fork Express, and other possibilities as well. This is all powered by our Markz portal. So everything that you see is part of Markz portal. Well, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. And please give your tips below, because there's probably a lot of fonts we missed. It's ever-evolving environment nowadays. Even on the desktop, things are changing so quickly. Adobe comes out with updates more frequently. Things are evolving so quickly. Canva is evolving so quickly. If you just look how far they've gone on video, it's just amazing. I'll put a video down below on some of those amazing evolutions that have taken place with Canva and video. But Canva for graphic design is also taking amazing leaps and bounds, and it cannot be overlooked. Many are using it. I love to use it. I love to use InDesign too, and Photoshop and Illustrator. However, the reality is there's other tools out there, and we have to all interchange between all of them. I even use Affinity Publisher. So going around from Affinity Publisher to InDesign to Canva, yeah, it's a real problem. And we here at Markzware have the solution. email us on sales@markzware.com if you want to be a beta tester for DesignMarkz. Hopefully that'll be very, very soon here with us. It's now in the final stages of approval in the Canva app store. All right, buddy. David Dilling on behalf of Marsha, wishing you a great day. Take care.